I'm Sebastian Davies, a learning experience expert at Dassault Systèmes. Hello, and welcome to this video on being successful with stretch. The stretch command is a versatile modification tool that lets us enlarge or reduce the size of entities in one direction. Depending on how we select an entity, we can stretch or move it using the same command to provide flexibility during the design. So, let's get started. When using stretch, the selection method defines how the entity or entities react to the command. By selecting the end nodes of these two lines and activating stretch, we can stretch these points while maintaining the position of the unselected points to the left of the lines. By selecting the entities rather than any specific nodes, the stretch command will allow us to move them. Using a crossing selection method with a right to left selection window, we can ensure the selection of the line end nodes and can stretch the lines simultaneously. Of course, if we are in a hurry, we can always select an entity and stretch it by simply clicking on a node and dragging it to the preferred position. The same principles apply to other entities, but results vary. Dragging the central grip of a rectangle moves that selection and automatically stretches the parallel lines. Clicking on a specific node and dragging stretches. Another way to stretch is to pick the entity, hold the shift key, and click the nodes we want to stretch, then release the shift key, click on the node to set the base point to stretch from, drag, and click to the preferred point. As we have seen, the selection method when stretching is very important. Here, we have a block and a rectangle. Using a crossing selection window that excludes the block's insertion point, because of this, the block is unaffected when executing the stretch. Using these simple selection rules lets us quickly modify and maintain our designs.